The word supervolcano is used to describe volcanoes which have produced the world's largest explosive eruptions, which at a minimum eject hundreds of cubic kilometers of volcanic rock in a single eruption. As an example, the most recent supervolcano to erupt on the planet originated from the Iroha caldera in Japan, which ejected more than 400 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock 22,000 years ago. This eruption formed the massive caldera which is now a bay adjacent to the city of Kagoshima that today contains the erupting Sakurajima volcano. Looking around South America, you can find a number of large calderas from similarly sized massive eruptions. One of these calderas is from a supervolcano which is still geologically active, as beneath its edifice is a massive magma reservoir with 22,000 cubic kilometers of molten rock. This dormant supervolcano is located in Argentina and is known as Cerro Galan. It is the only supervolcano within South America which could erupt again. The Cerro Galan supervolcano is located in northwest Argentina, where it is 200 kilometers southwest of the city of Salta. From satellite, its massive caldera rim is easy to distinguish alongside a central peak referred to as a resurgent dome. This caldera measures 40 kilometers long and 25 kilometers wide, which formed in a single supermassive eruption. Around 15 million years ago, volcanic activity started in this region of Argentina, producing clusters of gray stratovolcanoes and lava dome complexes. Over time, these volcanic centers slowly shifted eastwards until they reached the eventual site of Cerro Galan. Three stratovolcanoes were subsequently constructed, forming distinct peaks on the western edge of Galan's caldera. A significant change occurred around 6.6 million years ago, as not only did several distinct magma chambers merge, but they also became more silica-rich. This allowed for very large explosive eruptions to occur, similar in magnitude to the largest known eruptions from Mount Hudson in Chile, rating the volcanic explosivity index as a 6. Seven such highly explosive eruptions occurred between 6.5 and 3.8 million years ago, each depositing a distinct layer of highly welded pyroclastic rock known as ignimbrite. Several of these eruptions may have even formed distinct small calderas, but these were later obliterated if they ever even existed. Then, for the next 1.7 million years, only small volume eruptions occurred at Cerro Galan. During this time span, a massive amount of pressure continued to build underlying its edifice, along with hundreds of cubic kilometers worth of magma. Finally, 2.08 million years ago, something caused this pressure to be released, triggering a catastrophic eruption. Several vents simultaneously erupted along an earthward-facing fissure, ejecting a column of ash more than 45 kilometers into the atmosphere. As the day seemingly turned to night due to the density of falling ash, energetic kilometer-high pyroclastic flows seemingly defied topography as they traveled up mountains and advanced across the terrain in every direction. These flows buried everything in a 40-kilometer radius with hundreds of meters thick of rock, while also depositing smaller superheated layers of pyroclastic rock up to 80 kilometers distant. Then, as a portion of the underlying magma chamber was now empty, a large section of overlying ground collapsed downwards to fill this empty space, forming a massive caldera. In total, this caldera-forming eruption ejected 1,030 cubic kilometers of molten rock and had a volcanic explosivity index of 8, marking it as a true supereruption. Since some shallow magma remained, rhyodacite composition lava then erupted onto the edge of the caldera in two locations, forming large lava domes which are marked on screen. Over the subsequent 2 million years, magma has since refilled much of the area which subsided during the supereruption, which has pushed the center of Cerro Galan's caldera upwards, forming what is termed a resurgent dome. This massive dome was uplifted by more than 1,400 meters or 4,600 feet and continues to be slowly uplifted today. Although Cerro Galan is not presently showing signs of activity, it could erupt again in the future. Active hot springs and fumaroles around its complex are merely further evidence that its magma chamber is still present. Thus, the area should be actively monitored just in case this massive complex decides to produce another caldera-forming eruption. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Cameron Walker, for supporting this channel.